What's up, guys? In this video, we are going to take a look at Cardano. So for all you Cardano fans out there, strap in and make sure you stay tuned for the entire video. We will be taking a look at a couple of different time frames for Cardano on the daily chart, on the shorter term time frames, and giving you guys a few price targets. So make sure that you stay tuned. And if you're new to the channel and you love cryptocurrency, don't forget to smash that subscribe button. Hit that like button if you love this coin, if you love Cardano, if you love crypto, you want this video to reach more people, smash that like button, drop a comment in the comment section down below, and we'll jump right on into it. So the first thing I'm going to do is just check out this news article real quick over on newsbtc.com. It says Cardano aims to facilitate users with smart contracts. I know that this is something that has been talked about already, and I just want to give you guys my thoughts on this and cover this for you. So IOHK is the development team of the Cardano blockchain, and according to this team, Project Alonzo Testnet has moved from blue to white and is making it possible for Cardano to launch smart contracts. So the Cardano testnet had limitations. The first Cardano testnet may have offered smart contracts, but there were some limitations. The smart contract features it had were only for some people who are core insiders of the blockchain. According to the announcement, the new fork, Alonzo White, will run for 2 to 4 weeks. Then it will upgrade to the Alonzo Purple, which is the final testnet for this current phase of its development. The Cardano blockchain founder, Charles Hoskinson, is assuring the community that the team is following the roadmap that they set out earlier for the project. He also noted that Cardano had facilitated the sale of over $10 million worth of NFTs on its network. And after the announcement of the Alonzo White fork, a DeFi and NFT marketplace, Spores Network, disclosed that it had raised a whopping $2.3 million through its fundraising event on July 16th. According to the company, it plans to utilize the best features of Cardano, such as low transaction costs, higher transaction throughput, and low carbon footprint to make NFTs available for mainstream users. And currently, guys, Cardano is up almost 10% in the past 24 hours, trading at a nice $1.32. And next, we're going to jump right on into the price action. So stay tuned. And the first chart I'm going to have a look at is the 4-hour chart here for Cardano. And you can see what I'm paying attention to, guys. This is a beautiful breakout here. We did break our downtrend. Also, in my opinion, this is absolutely an inverse head and shoulders. We're going to take a look at that next. So here on the 4-hour chart, guys, I do have this inverse head and shoulders put in here. And I also have the neckline set at about, let's throw a line in there at our neckline here, which is at about $1.25. That would be the neckline, guys. And you can see, if I zoom in here, Cardano broke through this very nicely, as well as breaking our downwards trend resistance, that red trend line there. And in my opinion, guys, this is absolutely an inverse head and shoulders playing out here, as well as a break of our downtrend resistance. This is super bullish. Obviously, guys, there is a lot of bullish things happening right now in the crypto space. A lot of coins are making moves, but each of these coins have separate targets to pay attention to. So next, what I'm going to do is go ahead and zoom on out and show you guys the short-term price target here for Cardano. Keep in mind, this is not financial or investment advice. You should invest at your own risk. And if we zoom on out here, you can see exactly where this measure move will get us to. And stay tuned, guys, because next I will be giving you a longer term price target on the daily chart. So you can see we did break our downtrend resistance here, which is coming from all the way back here. And we broke to the upside above our neckline of our inverse head and shoulders. And this target, guys, if I would like to mention the fact that it gets you to retest this previous support and resistance level perfectly. Okay, that's right up here around $1.50, okay? Up here in between $1.45 and $1.50. So I do have that price target in there at approximately $1.47 for Cardano. You can see currently in the price action, we have traded to almost half of this measured move. And next, what I'll do is zoom out to the daily chart and show you guys a separate price target. So stay tuned. For this price target, guys, we're going to be paying attention to this longer term line of resistance and also this longer term line of support, as well as this potential descending wedge pattern. So the measure move of this as a potential descending wedge pattern would just be from the top to the bottom there of your pattern, taken to our breakout point here, gets us up around $2.10 to $2.35. This also makes sense because it does connect you here and get you to come up and retest your long-term resistance line. And zoomed in, guys, you can see that Cardano has broken out of this potential descending wedge pattern absolutely perfectly. So I do believe that our short-term price target of that inverse head and shoulders will likely play out, as well as continuing on up here to the upside here towards September. I do believe we could come up here and retest this long-term line of resistance up here around $2.10 to approximately $2.35. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this quick update on Cardano. Make sure you don't forget to smash that like button on the way out and hit that subscribe button if you're new. Also, come check out my other updates, guys. Lots of good price action updates. And I'll see you in the next one.